Now here we learn how to draw the orthographic projections by referring given pictorial view. Let us observe this object, and red arrow indicates the direction of observations for front view. Observe the given pictorial view carefully. Build up your imagination by observing pictorial view such that how this pictorial view appears when we observe through different angles. This imagination helps us to detect the clearly visible and hidden surfaces, its nature and its location. Thus, four pictorial views are represented, which we can get by observing through different angles. By carefully observations, overall dimensions trace are length is 90, height is 60, and width is 60. Prepare the frame for front view for which length is 90. Now construct the frame for top view for which length is 90 and width is 60 mm. Draw these lines by using the adapter. Draw frame for left hand right hand side view at a 20 mm distance from frame of front view. Its gap between these three frames should be 20 mm. Now we'll try to draw the front view. Now try to draw this blue color surface. Note down its all dimensions and draw it by lines which are parallel to the length and parallel to the height. Then consider this semi-cylindrical portion of a green color. Note down its length 30 mm, height is 30 mm. Now try to draw hidden portion of that cylindrical part. Draw this dotted line which will indicate the radius of a small circle. Now draw this next yellow color semi-cylindrical portion by dotted lines. Now we have to draw top view. For top view, start to draw this semi-cylindrical surface. Before this, draw the projections from front view. Now to draw this semi-cylindrical green color surface, take the 15 mm distance in compass and draw this semicircle. Now with same center point, take radius of 30 mm. And complete this semicircle. Thus, the top portion of this semi-cylindrical part is completed. Now, to draw this yellow color surface, mark its points along width. Width is 30 mm, and its length is 40 mm. Here is some mistake at the end of this video. This mistake is corrected, which is done in top view. Now we have to draw the side view. Take the projections from top view as well as a front view. we are projecting the semi-cylindrical portion from top view into side view. Draw the center line this green color semicircle which is visible in side view are drawn. A pink color surface as well as a yellow color surface, so green color surface is also drawn here. Now consider the hidden portion. Green color semi-cylindrical surface is not visible, so it is represented by dotted lines. Draw these dotted lines of a uniform line. This is a horizontal rectangular slot which is cut at the bottom, which is shown hidden in side view. Again, represent this horizontal slot which is cut at the bottom in top view by means of a dotted lines. Give the dimensions. Dimensions plays a very important role in your presentation of a drawing. Especially arrow size matters too much. Draw the numbers having equal heights. Height should be of a 4 to 5 millimeter. Use align dimension methods. We are drawing this vertical dimension line and placing the dimensions to the left side so that it can be readable from right side. This is the corrections. That is a slot, semi-cylindrical slot is shown in corrected manner. Dimension of a semicircle. Draw this leader line passing through the center point. Put note about dimensions of these semicircles. This length is 40 millimeter. Just in this way, try to give the dimensions. Never repeat the dimensions. Excessive dimension does not add any value to your drawing. Simply it disturbs the appearance of your drawing. Give only necessary and essential dimensions. Retain all construction lines. Thus, this will be your final solution. Retain line work, line thickness and darkness.